Today we're going to learn how to build two types of income statements from a NetSuite Safe Search. The first is going to be more of a board-ready income statement that looks something like this, and it also gives you the ability to select a different year, and then you'll see all your income and expenses populate here. And the second is more of a quick and dirty income statement. It's just a quick pivot table that allows you to filter on different subsidiaries, etc. So let's jump into it. The first thing we want to do is bring in a list of all the transactions that meet certain criteria. So essentially you're going to go to transactions, management, and then search transactions, and then choose posting accounts equal to true. So this will bring in all the accounts where there's a GL impact. Restrict the accounts to those of cost of goods sold, income, expense, other income, and other expense, because we're only looking at income and expenses. And I do suggest you choose a date range that lets you get as much data into Excel as possible. Once it's in Excel, then that's where you can really start slicing and dicing it, and you won't have to worry about connecting back up to NetSuite again and any connectivity delays, etc. The most important fields to bring in are going to be the internal ID, the date, subsidiary if you're using OneWorld, and the internal ID for the account, for your GL account, and then the name for your account. In some cases, you may want to use description, but that will be up to you guys. And then here's a handy formula that you can use. So if you drill down, say from a pivot table, you can actually get a hyperlink back to NetSuite. And then we're also going to bring in a list of GL accounts. So go ahead and just do a search based off your general ledger accounts, and then pull in some of this information here, as much as you need. We're going to want to be pulling in at least the account number, and then the display name or the description or the name. And this may vary based on your particular setup. Some people have their account names with account numbers and names. So you'll find a variation of this that allows you to have a one column with the GL account number right here, 1511, and then another one that will pull in the name. And then we're going to want to essentially recreate something like this. So we're going to get to the gross profit. We'll pull in all of this expense information here, and then we'll pull in cost of sales and the expenses. And we're also going to want to see this by month. Okay, so this is what we're going to try and recreate, everything from gross profit on up. And we want to make this in more of a board ready format, and then also the pivot table so we can do a little quicker analysis. So let's get started with a blank Excel worksheet. I'm going to load CloudExtend, and we're going to bring in the two saved searches I referenced. So we're going to bring in the income statement. And we also want to bring in the general ledger account. So I'm just doing a quick search for those two. Okay, got it. I'm going to add both of those. No need for me to preview these. I know these are the ones that I want. So let's create those. This is going to now run those two saved searches and bring my raw data right into Excel, ready for me to create my pivot tables, reports, etc. Okay, great. So we've got all the data that we need now to begin creating the income statement. Let's first just create a pivot table income statement. So I'm going to go to Insert. I'm going to go to Pivot Table. Go ahead and click on OK. And again, this is meant to be quick and dirty, but let's go ahead and bring in date as a column. One of the nice things about date is that it will automatically group by quarter and then by month. Next, we want to bring in account type. So I'm going to bring in account type here, and then let's bring in our account name. Next, let's collapse all of these fields. And now we can move these around a little bit, right? So we're going to want to bring in income to the top. So let's just drag income up to the top, other income up to the top. And then we've got cost of goods sold, expense, and other expense. And last, we want to bring in amount. And let's just filter our year so that we only have 2020 and 2021. Give them a format of currency. Just makes it a little easier on the eyes. and we can expand the fields. And now we've got something that looks a little bit more like an income statement, which we can add slicers to. So let's go ahead and do that right now. Let's add a slicer. Let's drop in a slicer for subsidiaries. So if we want to see an income statement for just one of these two subsidiaries, let's say the East subsidiary, we can click on that. And now we're seeing just the East. Want to see just the West, go ahead and click on that and then unfilter it. And you can add in any other slicers that you want to. If you want to slice on department, class, etc., you can. And you could also add those as dimensions to your pivot table. So that's a quick and dirty way to build a pivot table. Now let's go ahead and take a look at how to create one that looks a little bit nicer. And again, this requires a little more effort, but you only need to put that effort in one time. The first thing I want to do is add a place for me to select the year. So I'll go ahead and add that in here. So the next thing we want to do here is give this cell reference a name. It's going to be a little bit easier to refer to this as a name. It's a little easier on the eyes. So let's go ahead and do that here. And we'll call this something like income statement year. Okay, so we've got our year defined. Now we're going to want to find a place to bring in our GL account. So I'm just going to come over here. We'll just type account number. So we know that's going to be the account number. We'll come over and we'll add a revenue header. Here we'll use our first formula. So this is going to be where we want to define the first month of the year. In order to do this, I'm going to refer back to H2, but it's a little easier on the eyes. Remember, we created this name for that single cell range. So here's the formula that we're going to use, and that's going to automatically assign January 2020. Now, next we need to create another formula for the next cell. So here we're using the Excel edate formula. So that's going to return the first day of the month following the date that is in the previous cell. And now we can extend this all the way out until we get to December. Okay, so now we've got our header rows. And notice that those will change. If we change the year to 2021, all those references change to months in 2021. Let's go back to 2020. And now we're going to start dropping in some GL accounts. So we know we have a GL account 4000. In fact, let's shift account number over and let's put the account number underneath here. Okay, so here is the GL account 4000. And now we need a formula that's going to look up the account name from the list of GL accounts that we downloaded. And here we're just going to use Excel's XLOOKUP formula. So we're looking for the value in C7. That's the GL account. And we want to return the description in our case for that GL account. So in this case, it's going to return sales. And let's go ahead and just add a few more GL accounts here and drop this formula down. And here you can see that the account number is now being used to pull in something a little more easy on the eyes. So here we've got two options to create, to calculate the value of the GL for a particular month. So essentially what we want to do is take a look at all of this data we pulled from the income statement. And we want to sum the amount by the GL account number. So here is the GL account number right here, 6182, whenever it falls within a given date range. So for something like that, we typically want to use Excel's sum if S formula. So here's a sum if S formula that is going to sum up the amount whenever we find the GL account within a specific date range. And a copy of this formula is available to you for your reference on our support site. Let's go ahead and pop that in. And here we can see that for the month of January 2020, the sales for account 4000 should be $230,318.20. And we can cross-reference that with what we see in NetSuite's own report right here for accuracy. Now let's go ahead and format this as currency. And reduce the number of decimal points. Now, one thing we've got to do here is we've got to don't just drag this formula out. We've got to copy it, then select all the remaining cells, and then we can paste it. So now we should see these same numbers. Let's just do another cross check for November and December, 12,590 and 922. So we've got 12,590 and 922. So we know we're on the right track, right? And now we're just going to add in a total, and we can do a sum of this entire range. And now we can just drag this formula down. Adjust our columns a little bit. In fact, we can even close the add-in right now. So we've got our revenue. We also, now we want to add a line for total revenue. And we're just going to use an Excel sum function. And we can drag this all the way across as well and bring this column, bring this formula down as well. So this is everything we need on our revenue side. And now we're going to go ahead and bring in our cost of sales and some of the expenses. So let's add cost of sales here. I already have some GL account numbers that I know I'm going to want to bring in. And I can just copy my lookup formula and now drag this down. And I can just copy my formulas from above here as well. And now I just drag this down and we can add another total. And then let's go ahead and add our gross profit as well. So the gross profit is total revenue minus the total cost of sales. And we can drag this out as well, expand our columns a tad. So we'll do another quick cross check here. Our gross profit in Excel is $3,514,000. And here we go over here in NetSuite, it's $3,514,000. So with some reasonable certainty, we're mimicking this Excel financial statement. And now we can just clean this up a little bit. So we'll apply some formatting to this. First thing I like to do is just go ahead and get rid of the grid lines. And then we can make year bold. A little bit bigger. We can actually hide the account numbers. And let's make these headers here bold. And we'll do some right alignment. And in fact, let's make all these bold. And let's go ahead and put some borders on here as well. Let's just make this whole row here bold. And here we'll add a top border. And let's do the same thing for cost of sales. Let's add a top border. And then on gross profit, let's add a double underline border. And let's go ahead and insert a trend line as well. So we'll go ahead and highlight January through December. We'll go to insert and let's just go ahead and add a spark line. And we can do the same thing for the gross profit. All right, so now we've got a spark line, our formatting, everything looks pretty good. Let's see, what else can we do here? You can also go ahead and insert your company logo just to put a nice little touch on it. So now we can also go ahead and just change the year here, right? Because these formulas will now reflect a different year. So if we want to see 2020 versus 2021, really easy to do right here. Now let's go back to 2020 and I'm going to show one advanced formula. So this is something new in Excel. You may, Let's see, it's May 4th, 2021 when I record this. Not everyone has this particular feature available yet, but this is something called an Excel Lambda, and it's also a little more easy on the eyes, right? So if I'm looking here and I see this sum if s statement, and I'm not an Excel expert, and I'm not, this takes a few seconds to really figure out exactly what it's trying to do. So to create an Excel Lambda, and our help site also has references to other sites we found useful in creating these lambdas, is we want to come up and define a name. So we want to create a new name. And we're going to give this a name. We're going to call this income statement month amount. So INCSTMT month amount. And what this is telling the Lambda to do is it's saying, go ahead and do a sum if s, as we defined earlier, and send over account and month. And so whatever we choose first in the formula as account will be account and then month. So let's go ahead and drop this in. So now we've created that Lambda formula. So now if we come up here and start typing the name of the formula, here's the Lambda that we just created, income statement month and amount. And it's going to, the first thing we need to do is put in the GL account. In order to do this, we're going to need to unhide these columns first. So let's go ahead and unhide these columns so we can get at the GL accounts. All right, let's come back to this. So now we're going to come up and change this formula to equals income statement month amount. The first parameter is going to be the GL account number, and the second is going to be the date. And let's fix this so that we're always referring to the column C and to row 6. Now we can drag this out and we can extend this down. And we can start to copy and paste this to the rest of our spreadsheet as well. So now in this spreadsheet, we have a much nicer looking formula that's a lot easier to reference. So I really hope that this helps you guys take our CloudExtend Excel Analytics application, build those saved searches, refresh them on demand, put them on schedules, and then come in and look and see that you've got the most recent set of data that's available, whether it's in a pivot table or whether it's in some other type of report that you've gone ahead and built that works for you. Thanks again for watching. Look forward to seeing what you can build with CloudExtend Excel Analytics for NetSuite.
If you need further support, please visit our support site at support.cloudextend.io.